kind of notice that you're coming into these opening moments of the practice, how do you feel? It's like, what's really alive for you right now? Just noticing maybe like tightness or what sensations are showing up. Maybe it's a feeling. Maybe it is wondering, or maybe it's nothing at all. Whatever it is, just begin to breathe into it, to give it space. It's so important to have an anchor, something that when we drift, we have the ability to come back to the moment. So choose an anchor. Maybe that anchor is your breath. Maybe that anchor is sound. Maybe that anchor is the sensations of the body. Every time you notice that your mind has drifted away, can you come back to the sounds that are right here, or the breath, or this body? Remembering that when it gives its attention to the thinking, right, when our attention goes to there, because thinking's always happening, it also draws us into feeling a certain way. And with this ability to anchor back to here, to what's in this moment, your breath, the sounds around you, this body right now. You're practicing building a pathway in your brain to be here. No matter how often you need to begin again, giving your attention, making the object, the focus of your attention, either breath or sound or sensation, you begin again as often as you need to. Sounds. start to bring into this moment some very natural movement. Just like the movement even of awakening. Right? Maybe that is like the morning stretches you have. I'm getting a glimpse into what happens in the morning. And that is, well, that's how you stretch in the morning? Oh, okay, that's what you do. Yeah, what is that like for you? A little twist, a stretch, whatever that is. It's a little glimpse into your world, right? Keep the breath going, the noticing of breath. And then over the next several breaths, you'll begin to make your way to hands and knees. The sunrise this morning was glorious. I don't know if we noticed that. It actually looks like a beautiful day in the making. When you get to hands and knees, your shoulders are over your wrists and your knees are under your hips. And really spread the fingers out, feel energy in the hands, and take a breath, release the belly and the rib cage, and tilt the heart up. Good, and then exhale, pushing the mat away around the spine, kind of hollow out the armpits. Good, keep going just like that. Inhale, release the belly and the rib cage, tilt the heart up. Exhale, round the spine. A few more like that. Now, when you move like this in this direction, know that you can also move side to side, whatever it feels like the body needs now. And stay very attuned to either breath or sound or sensations. Maybe all of it comes into play as you open up into this moment. Yeah, thanks for this breath. Thanks for being here. And then start to breathe into stillness. And feel the belly draw up and in. But with that belly in, see if you can still get deep breath. Yeah, pushing the mat away, lift underneath the armpits, and then tuck the toes, just tuck the toes. Take a breath in. And exhale, hover the knees, just to hover. If that's too much, profound statement coming up, then don't do it, right? If it's too much, don't do it. Hollow out a little bit, rounding, breathe in. Downward facing dog, breathe out. Is that like the best moment right there, the down dog moment? I feel like I might have been like that. But we're gonna go back to the other moment in just a second. So inhale, lift the heels up. Exhale, come to that hovering hands and knees. So get your shoulders over your wrists and your knees, there you go, knees under the hips. Breathe into it. Take a full breath in. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good. Let's do that again. It looks like a lot of fun right now. Inhale, lift the heels up. Exhale, hovering hands and knees. Keep the hands really strong. Hollow out the belly. Take a breath in. Good. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a very slow walk to your hands. Like pausing along the way to stretch, to really notice the sensations in the body. And when you get eventually to the top of the mat, open the feet as wide as feels good for your body and catch your elbows. And notice breath in. And feel the weight back a little farther maybe and notice the breath out. Yeah, and if you'd like to move in this, go ahead. You can sway side to side, you can oppositionally bend the knees. You're just noticing full breaths in. You're noticing your feet on the ground, full breaths out. So the topic that I wanted to kind of work through in class today, physically, obviously mentally, and then totally emotionally, is this concept of real but not true. I'll just leave a cliffhanger right there. So take a breath in. Good. Exhale. Release just the left hand or the left fingertips down and stretch the right arm up to the windows. All the way up. Make sure your hand can touch, even if you need to bend your knees to do that. Take a very full breath in. Exhale. Right hand down, left hand up to the wall.
Take a full breath in. Exhale, bring the left hand down and the right arm. I was saying how I hate this cue because there's a song that says to the window, to the wall. And then the lyrics that follow are horrifying. And every time I cue this, I'm like, I should start to the wall because I start to the window. Take a breath in, exhale, right hand down, left hand up. I'm so sorry if you know the lyrics and now that's in your head. Your left hand is up toward the wall. Take a full breath in. Exhale, hand down, walk your feet back to hip bone distance. Good. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, empty out and fold. Good, rise to standing. Inhale, press down, reach all of the way up. Exhale, empty out, fold forward. Yeah, halfway lift on a breath. Exhale, plant the hands, step back to a top of a push-up. And please understand that on the top of a push-up, if the breath is very challenging, you'll lower the knees down. But keep the thigh bones lifted. That cat-cow feeling when you grounded, bring that in. Feel the belly lift. Good. Take a full breath in. Exhale, lower all of the weight of the mat. Sun salutation, Mary. Come into cobra on an inhale. Exhale through knees or through plank, downward facing dog, where you take a full belly breath in. Stay here. Take a full breath out. You got it. Take another deep belly breath in. And on your exhale, step, walk, or jump the feet to your hands. Halfway lift on a breath. Exhale, empty out and fold. Rise to standing. Press down. Reach all of the way up. Exhale, empty out and fold forward. Halfway lift on a breath. With an exhale, plant the hands, step back to plank or modify with knees down. Pause, take a very full breath in. Exhale, lower all of the way down the mat. Come into the tops of the feet, lift the heart, light hands, cobra. Exhale through knees or through plank, downward facing dog. Breathe, pause. The real but not true becomes this this learning, this understanding, this awareness of things feel very real, but are often not true. It might feel like we are going to do this till the end, like keep going over and over and over again. There's something that's not true, but there might be something in your head that's like, I wonder how many, just, I don't know, 12, 15 more. Take a breath in. Exhale, step, walk, or jump the feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale and fold. Rise to standing. Press down. Reach all of the way up. Keep it moving. Exhale. Fold forward. Halfway lift on a breath. Plant the hands to plank or modify. From this place, take a very full belly breath in. Now make a choice. Lower halfway or all of the way. Come through to cobra with those bent elbows or up dog. You come to the tops of your feet. Good. Exhale. Add a push-up or not. Downward facing dog. I'll talk you through that one more time, then you're on your own. Take a breath in. Exhale, bring the feet to the hands. Halfway lift on a breath. Exhale and fold. Rise all the way to standing. Press down through your feet, reach up through your arms, and then fold forward. Exhale. Good, halfway lift. And then move it through that vinyasa flow, or you step right back to down dog. Good. You're on your own for just a few moments. I'm not really going away, but I'll be right back. Stay connected to that anchor as you move. Right, the sounds of your breath, the feeling of it, the way the body feels in this place. And you're just moving in and moving out of these poses. And now, let the sound of the breath be what takes over. Yeah, so that becomes the object, feelings, what keeps you right here is that. You gotta take breaths in and breaths out.
There is no way in hell that I could listen to that the entire time. I'm going to change the song a little bit once in a while. Every 40 seconds, but they put a song, the whole song. Keep moving. Keep breathing. Keep noticing breath in. Noticing breath out. Notice how your feet feel. So the truth, as we go through that, the truth is that you're here and you're moving. Yeah, that's the truth. The truth is that you're breathing, that there's sounds around you. So just begin to identify what's true. Often not the thoughts, right? Often not the thoughts. Let's go through that sun salutation two more times. That was a true statement. That was true. Two more times. Tammy bought me a shirt that said swearing helps. That's also true. So what's true from the sensations in the body that you notice? All right, that's true. You got it. When you finish those sun salutations, find a place to pause, a pose that feels very honest for your body. Breath in, breath out. You're in this place of pause. Practice of what's true first here. What's true is how your body feels. From a sensation standpoint, that's true. What's true is the way the room that you're in, what it looks like, that's true. Establish in this body that you're in what's true. Not the story of the body or the story of the room or the story of the people around you, just the truth of it. Bringing another deep breath in where you are. And a very long breath out. And then start to make your way back to downward facing dog if you're not there. Take a deep breath in, feel your hands on the mat. Take a long breath out. Lift your right leg up on an inhale. And then bend your knees, stack your hips as you exhale. Now when you do that, if you roll to the pinky toe side of the left foot, feel the inner thigh, the left inner thigh, push a little bit more in our room toward the windows here, right? There we go again. Take a breath in. And on the exhale, bring your right knee towards your right tricep up really high. Come far forward, good. Inhale, kick it back up to that bent knee. Kick it back up to bent knee. Good, exhale, bring the knee to the tricep. Maybe you bend the elbows. Keep your hands really strong. Do that again. Inhale, kick it all the way up. Bend the knee. Come back to either knee to tricep or bent elbows or straight. And hold for two rounds of breath, please. Hold for two rounds of breath. And then you'll place the foot in between the hands. Yeah. And come on up to crescent lunge. Stack shoulders over hips. The back knee can come down for more support. Keep the front knee over the ankle in alignment. Good. So what's real in this pose? The sensations that are coming up. So scan the body. What's real? What's to be known here? Breathe. Take a very full breath in. And as you exhale, make your way back to down dog. And that always has the option of a flow or pausing in plank. One time I saw someone throw some jumping jacks in, a little old school thing happened there. Wasn't ready for that, but we worked through it. Make your hands really strong. A little running man, a little something in there. Take a breath in, lift the left leg up. Exhale, bend the knees, stack the hips. All right, again, bring awareness to the right thigh. If you feel the outside of that right foot bearing more weight, draw the right inner thigh towards center more. That's it. Take a full breath in here. Exhale, left knee, left tricep. Good. Inhale, kick it all the way back up. Bend the knee. Good. Exhale, right, left knee, left tricep. You can bend the elbows or not. Good. Inhale, lift it back up. Exhale, come back into it. Left knee, left tricep, bend elbows, and you're going to hold it for 2 rounds of breath. And then you'll place the foot in between the hands. And then you'll come up to high crescent lunge. Breathe it all the way up. Remember, the back knee can come down for more support. And this is just the tangible experience, the opportunity to tap into what's true right here. Practice that from a body sensation standpoint. What's true? Take a deep belly breath in. And with your exhale, make your way back to down dog. Now that I've offered the jumping jack thing, I don't know. Dive into that. Notice the next breath in and the next breath out. You're more than welcome to simply hold in down dog if that works for you. Or once again, lift the right leg up on an inhale. Bend the knee, stack the hips with an exhale. You can stay here or tap the right knee to the right tricep. You can stay here or bend the elbows. There's all sorts of places to go. Good. Take a deep belly breath in from wherever you are. Place the right foot in between the hands. Nice. Come up, high crescent lunge. So the options are nice because I think they give an opportunity for you to have some truth to your practice, right? What's true for you in your practice? Not the story of what you feel like you should do. You got it. From crescent lunge, take a full belly breath in. This time, exhale, warrior two. Swivel the back heel down, right arm forward, left arm back. Front knee is bent. Yeah. Make sure the front knee's not caving forward. Yeah, it's a little bit of a bigger stance step than before. There you go. Seal the outside of the left foot against the floor. Soften the skin of the shoulders. Flip the right palm. Inhale, lift, stretch up and back, and straighten the right leg. But go back to warrior two as you exhale, re-bend the right knee. Do that again. Flip the palm. Inhale, stretch up and back, and straighten the right leg. Exhale, deep bend in the right knee, warrior two. One more time. Flip that palm, straighten the right leg, but this time side angle. So right forearm to right quad, or right hand down to the floor. So this is great. Let me tell you this. This is the true story I'm going to tell you right now, right here. Are you breathing? Heidi called me. We were talking about the logistics of everything, and she was like, I should have recorded it. She said, nobody really needs blocks. I was like, see? I told you that nobody really needs blocks. If you don't know, Heidi's like, block, 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 block. Yeah? Yeah. Yes. Show that five. That's it. Good. All right. Come all the way back to reverse warrior. Straight, but straighten the right leg. So reach the right fingertips back. Take a deep breath in and then make your way back to down dog, however it works. Heidi, finally you see everything my way. And pause wherever you are and breathe into what is true. Truth anchors in sensations in the body. And say that again. Truth anchors in sensations. What do you notice? Lift the left leg. Good. And then bend the knee and stack the hips. And remember, you can stay right here or you can stay in down dog, right? Take a full breath in.
And if you choose to, as you exhale, tap the left knee to the left tricep. This is a choice. From this choice, you might stay here or you might bend the elbows. Yeah, and notice breath in and notice breath out. And then place the foot in between your hands and come on up to high crescent lunge. Breathe it all the way up. Soften the skin of the shoulders. Full breath in. Long breath out, warrior two. Swivel the back heel down, left arm forward, right arm back. Kind of eyes past the front fingertips. And then tune into the truth of the body. Make sure the left knee never goes past the toes. Yet stacked there and a press into the outside of the right foot. Good. Flip the left palm, stretch up and back and straighten the left leg. Inhale to warrior two as you exhale. Bend that left knee. Do that again. Flip the palm, inhale, stretch back, and straighten the left leg. Exhale, bend the left knee, warrior two. Keep weight in the back foot still. And then again, flip the left palm, stretch up and back, and straighten the left leg. Let's go to side angle, left forearm to quad, or left hand on the inside or outside of that leg. Maybe the right arm goes over the ear. There you go. Deepen the breath. Full breaths in. You got it. And this is the great opportunity, because sometimes stories come up in poses. Thoughts come in. That's not true. That's just for example, I've not seen a leg fall off from doing this, or the arm. These things are how long this is forever. No. No storm lasts forever. Good. Go back. Flip the left palm. Straighten the left leg. Full breath in. Reach all the way back. Good, and then exhale, make your way back to down dog.
So just this exploration, right?
Keep anchoring in sensations in order to anchor in truth. And then find a place of pause for you. And that might be plank, right? Some of you might want to stay physically engaged. That might be child's pose. That might be on hands and knees, but find a place for you to be still, to be anchored in, to practice, and continue to practice here. What's true right now? It might be true that you feel something. You have a feeling. It's the truth of it. Take four more deep breaths in. And out. As the body makes its way to down dog, right now, what's true? This is how I feel. This is what I notice. Remember, you can stay in down dog or on an inhale, lift the right leg up. Choice to exhale and bend the knee. New choice to flip or not. Right, that right foot comes down, the right arm reaches up. You got it. Breathe, and wherever you are is perfect. As you breathe out, bring the right knee to the right tricep or don't. Bend the elbows or don't. Pause for two rounds of breath. When you get to the end of that second breath, place the foot in between the hands and rise up high crescent lunge. I almost said left foot, and you guys follow directions so well, I expect to see a big jump.
That was comparing me
Yeah, take a full breath in right here. And then warrior two as you exhale, back heel down. Beautiful. Flip the right palm, inhale, stretch up and back and straighten the right leg. And then into side angle as you exhale, forearm to quad or to the... We don't need a block, Heidi. Yeah. Some of you have those props. You have water bottles are great too. You can use that. Bring water bottles in. And if you bought your props, use them. You got it. Where's the breath?
All right, come back and straighten the right leg and reach the right arm back. Take a full breath in. Let's head into triangle. Exhale, hand to shin, ankle, foot, or floor. Arms straight up. This is not about your hand down to the ground. That would be a story that would feel very real if you told it to yourself. So that's the thing about real but not true. The thing about real but not true is it feels so real. Some of these stories we tell ourselves. Yeah, stay in your sensations. That's how you stay in truth. Stay in the facts of what we know. You got it. Head back to warrior two. Rebend the right knee. Extend the arms. Beautiful. Flip the right palm again. Inhale. Stretch back. Keep the right knee bent this time. Grab the right wrist with the left hand and give yourself a little draw to the back of the room, but keep bending the front knee. Give that a really nice stretch. Good. And then exhale through vinyasa or straight back to down dog or however you're pit stopping along the way and breathe. I'm sure that's clearly understood why this is the message today, right? Because there are some things that feel very real, but they are not true. Stay grounded in the sensations of the body, but also in the facts. Okay. You can stay right here or lift the left leg. Take a breath in. Stay here or bend the knee. Stay here or flip. These options, your choice. Beautiful. Taking a full breath in. When you come back around, if you flipped, as you exhale, bring the left knee to the left tricep, elbows bent or not, or don't do that part. Pause for two breaths. Keep pushing the mat away. There you go. Then place the foot in between the hands, the left one, and rise up. High crescent lunge. Inhale, reach it up. And then the back heel lands as you exhale into warrior two. Make sure that front knee is stabilized over the ankle. Press into the outside of the back foot and breathe. There you go. Flip the left palm, inhale, then stretch up and back, and maybe give that left leg a straighten for just a moment, and then head into side angle as you exhale. Now keep giving weight to your back foot. Same thing again. Yeah, there you go. And feel the underside, the left side of the body, lift and elongate as you stretch the right fingertips over the head. Beautiful. Notice this breath. Through. Come back. Keep the left knee bent. Come back to warrior two. Pause right here. Now flip the left palm. Keep the left knee bent again. Exhale. Stretch back. Grab the left wrist with the right hand and feel it draw toward the back of the room. But bend the left knee. Good. Full breath in. This exhale, bring your hands down to frame your left foot, but then step the right foot forward to meet it. Halfway lift on a breath. Exhale and fold. From the ground up, build chair. Bend the knees. Sweep the arms up. Trust the back side of your body. So if the knees are knocking in, press, use the outside leg muscles. There you go. Feel the toes press down. Take the strain out of the throat. There's truth and sensations. Facts and a logical mind. Draw your hands to heart center. Hover your belly over your thighs. Take a full breath in. Without popping the left knee forward, take the outside of the left arm against the right leg. So that elongated side that we felt before, I want that same thing. So feel the left underside of your body lengthen. Drag the left sit bone back. Try not to cave the knees in. And feel a lift up on the right side of the body. Take a breath in. Good. Take a breath out. Quick fold over the legs. And then halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale to fold from the ground up. Bend the knees and reach the arms up. Build chair. Again, trying to not cave the knees in. Taking those full breaths in and long breaths out. Soften the throat. Step the hands to heart center. Cover the belly over the thighs, full breath in, take that twist
outside of the right arm against that left leg. Now the knees knocking in, elongate the underside of the body. And then notice if there's strain that's happening. Never purpose for that. Draw a breath in. Fold over your legs as you exhale. Halfway lift. Refold on the exhale. Rise all the way to standing. Press down. Reach up. Take the outside of the right ankle against the left thigh. And then bend the left knee. Hands can come to heart center. They can stay extended. And if the ankle bone on the thigh hurts, just overcross it so it's not quite there. If your right sit bone is lower than your left, lift up the right sit bone. That might bring your knee up. It might not open as much. Grounding in the truth of sensation. Lift the right leg up in front of you and straighten the left and reach the arms up. Take a breath in. And then warrior three. So you can go right into that. Tap the toes down also. So you can kick the toes back behind you as they're lengthened. The arms can extend forward and they can stay at heart center. Take the strain out of the throat. Where's the breath? I'm going to head right to warrior two from here. So land the right foot, the left knee bends, the arms are extended. Good. Flip the left palm, inhale, lift, stretch up and back, and straighten the left leg. Grab triangle down the leg here as you exhale. Yeah, so both legs are straight. Good. That's it. Rounding in. Yeah. Sound through your feet. Use the inner thighs. Ah, the man, elongate. Feel it lift through the belly. Take a breath in and a breath out. And then just bring the hands down to frame the left foot. Step the right foot forward again. Halfway lift on a breath. Exhale to fold. Rise to standing. Press down. Reach up. Take the left ankle over the right thigh and bend the right knee. So I'm certain, like me, you can spin, especially with what's occurring right now. You can spin into stories and worries that feel very real. To ask the simple question, is it true? Open up across the heart. Lift the left leg, straighten the right. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, kick that back into warrior three. Now, belly button lines up over the ankle for that balance. Remember, the left toes can simply touch down, make the spine longer. Lift up the back side of the body just a bit more. That's it. Take a full breath in and a long breath out. And come back to standing, top of the mat. Inhale, arms all the way up. Exhale, re-bend the knees and sit to chair. Got options. Hug the belly over the thighs. Take a breath in. Twist toward the windows outside the left arm against the right leg. Side crow. You want to explore that. Start to lower your sit bones down. Lift your heels up. Flatten your hands down. Your fingertips point toward the right side of the room. The elbows are bent. Use a breath. You got it. Take a full breath in. And from where you are, forward fold. You'll land the feet if you were flying and come into a forward fold just for a moment. Halfway lift down and inhale. Exhale to fold. Build a chair from the ground up. From chair, your hands come to heart center. You take a very deep belly breath in. And then you twist in the opposite direction, instead of the right arm against that left leg. There you go. You might stay right here, elongating, trying not to tip the chest too far forward. Draw the heart back. Or, yeah, side pose. Right. Breath. You got it. Together, you draw a full breath in. And as you exhale, if your feet are in the air, land them and come into a forward fold. Likely an unnecessary cue. I don't know if you would have folded without your feet on the ground. All right, open the feet.
and interlace the hands behind the back. Please bend the elbows so that you can close the palms.
The stories that we tell ourselves, whether it's happening now or always, really, it's heightened now. Those stories can become something that feel very real, but they're not true. And from that space, make this panic far, far worse. And it's unintentional, and we've practiced it unintentionally. And we can be compassionate for others during these times or ourselves when we notice these fears. But the only way to notice is to practice this anchor. Come into the truth of the body, to this breath. Sounds around you, right? Sensations. So take a full breath in. Exhale, release the hands down. Bring the feet back to hip bone distance. Halfway lift on a breath. And move through vinyasa or separate back to down dog. Grounding in what's true, like grounding in that. Options, always options. Maybe lift the right leg, breathe in. Maybe bend the knee, maybe flip it, breathe out. Your choice. You got it. Lift the heart, take a full breath in. Maybe you bring the right knee to the right tricep. Maybe you bend the elbows. Maybe this becomes an arm balance where you give a little bit of trust to the left leg. Good. Wherever you are, breathe in. Place the right foot in between the hands. High crescent lunge. Inhale, reach it all the way up. That means. And then exhale, warrior two, please. Roll the back heel down. Flip the right palm. Inhale, lift, stretch up and back, and straighten the right leg. Exhale, just straight to triangle, please. Both legs straight. Triangle has options. You're more than welcome to stay right here or turn this into half moon. If you're doing that, your eyes turn down toward the floor. The hand, the right hand, does not need to touch the floor. You can lift that left leg up. And breathe into this. Remember, you don't have to do this. You can stay in triangle. So from where you are, open up a little bit more. Take a full belly breath in. And now head back to warrior two. We'll all meet there together, front knee bends. Keep the front knee bent. Flip the right palm. Stretch up and back on an inhale. And as you exhale, bring the left hand down and the right hand up. So face the window. The left heel lifts up. Left hand down, right hand up. Good. So the back heel's over the ball of the foot. You can stay right here. You can modify side plank by lowering the left knee under the left hip, or you can roll to the outside of the left foot and then stack the feet. Keep the hips lifted. Keep the breath fluid. You can also flip this. If that right leg is lifted, you can tap the right toes back behind you and lift the heart, or any other variation. I'm interested if you can hand sanitize while you do this as well, but we'll see. Lots of variations. All right, is that good? You want to say one more breath? Find your way back to downward facing dog. Now I'm just messing with you. I just noticed. In this moment, what's true, you know that doesn't have to all be good things, right? But it can be. But like, what's true in this moment? Not flowing in like an out. Notice that. And acknowledge that some things feel very real. They are not the truth. Lift the left leg. That's a choice. Bend the knee, a choice. Flip it or not, right? Whatever you choose, breathe into it. Beautiful. Yeah. Now maybe when you come around, you bring the left knee to the left tricep. Keep that breath going, or maybe you don't. Maybe you bend the elbows, and maybe that flies in the air. Yeah. Full belly breath in. And as you exhale, find a way to get that left foot, hoist it in between the hands, rise up, high crescent lunge, full breath in. And let's go right to warrior two. Exhale to the windows. Flip the left palm, inhale to stretch up and back, and straighten the left leg, please. Come into triangle with an exhale, left hand down, right hand up. This triangle can stay as a triangle or come into half moon, where you bend the left knee and get the right hip stacked over the left and the right leg lifts and open up across the heart and breathe into that.
Yeah. Yeah, breathing here.
Warrior two, please. Put the left palm, inhale, lift, stretch up and back. And as you exhale, bring the right hand down, the right heel up, and the left arm up. And this can stay as is. You can stay right here. Or this can become side plank. A choice to lower the knee under the hip, that's it. Arm stays lifted, breath stays fluid. Deep belly breaths in. Long breaths out. Take a very full breath in. Breath out. Two more breaths. Two more breaths before you make your way back to down dog, and then you find your way into a place of stillness and silence. Find a place of pause. That's either child's pose or on your knees with eyes closed. To dive a little deeper into this exploration of real, but not true, you might find it a powerful strategy off of your mat. You notice that you're getting into the stories that we are all likely in some fashion, at some level, getting into. You get to ask that question. And ground in the body sensation and ground in facts. Take three more deep breaths where you are. And we're transitioning into a hip opener of choice. That can be pigeon, traditionally from down dog. That can be laying down. When we were standing and we crossed the ankle over the thigh, that's what it looks like on your back. You can also take that standing as well. So over the next few breaths, we can make that transition. To the hands. In these poses, more of stillness than movement, it's a good time to practice the anchoring. Thank you.
returning maybe again and again what this body in truth needs in this moment. Take four more rounds of breath. Before the transition, whatever way is best for you, happens to the other side. I feel very grateful, privileged in some ways, that I have this practice of mindfulness meditation, that I've practiced so that the pathways in my brain of like coming back into the moment are deep. But even with the practice, I am finding myself traveling down the road of stories of worry, of fear. And when I find myself traveling down that path, I simply pause and anchor back to the moment. I say simply, but what really happens is over and over again, I do that. So it's a simple cue that is in a lot of repetition for me right now. This is the practice, so that my emotions don't hijack my logic. Take another deep breath in, and another long breath out, and then make your way one more time to downward facing dog. Yes, that's true. Make your down dog just a little shorter than normal. And don't force the feet down, but trust the backside of the body for a little more weight. And then very tiny movement of alternatingly bending one knee and then the other, but to really breathe into the outside of the hips, like just feel that. Breathe into the legs. Yeah. Slow movement here. Mm-hmm. And then maybe you take that slow walk through the hands so that you can lay down. And lift the legs straight up. Soften the shoulders. Can you believe we're going to end with the tiniest bit of ab? How did that? Yes, that's what's happening. Soften the shoulders. Make this light. Soften the face. Maybe the knees have a tiny bend to them, but bring your right leg to a place like a hover or higher where you can sustain it and breathe. So that it's not something incredibly traumatizing to you, right? It's not that. It's something you can breathe into and feel the strength of your body. Now, feel the belly, engage the core, slower than you want to, change which leg is in a hover. Slower than you want to. Yeah, maybe the legs move simultaneously in slowness and deepen the breath. So I want you to do just this at your pace. And if you'd like a little bit more intensity to it, maybe taking the hands back behind the head and lifting the shoulder blades works. Maybe that gives you what you need, but I would love to hear breath. And the anchoring and the really the noticing of how you can do any activity slower to bring more presence to it. Yeah. Notice breath in. You got it. Notice breath out. Beautiful. Just a few more, just like that. And then pause wherever you are, pause, breathe. Come breathe in and breathe out. Slower than you want to, draw your knees into your chest. Yeah. Slow it all down. Extend the arms out to the sides and drop both knees to the right. Take your eyes to the left. The practice of anchoring becomes a way to ground in what's true. And I know so much of what we're going through can feel very real. Draw your knees through center. Drop them to the opposite side. Maybe the right ear turns down to the floor and you notice breath in and you notice breath out. Bring back to center. Draw the knees into the chest. And last time, extend the legs straight up. No abs on this one. Soften the space in between your eyes. Unhinge your jaw. Smooth out the skin of the shoulders. And together, draw a breath in. And give it a long breath out. You can head into Shavasana, legs straight down, or if you prefer, coming directly up for seated meditation. So Shavasana, opportunity to rest. Seated meditation and this awakening. Choosing the anchor. The practice of listening to sound or breath or sensations. You're more than welcome to stay in this place of Shavasana, laying down in this space of rest, and also transition to a seated position slowly. This anchoring practice, this noticing, this awareness of breath and sound and body. It doesn't mean for me in my practice that there are no thoughts that get me swept away. It means the awareness of them is there. And then the ability to give my attention for something else to become the object of my awareness. It's a worthy practice. And so in this moment, as we practice staying very true to our body and to the facts, bring your attention to just one thing, whether that be breath or sound or physical sensation. And when you notice the mind has wandered, right? Because it thinks, you're training the mind to give attention to something else, you just simply come back. Throughout today's meditation, you will hear the sound of the chime once. The sound of the chime is then the reminder that if you have drifted, to come back. Anchor back into the moment with breath or sound or sensation. to know that if you drift away, practice is that of coming back to what's true. This breath, these sounds, this body right here with its sensations. You're seated, really tune in and notice the way in which you're holding the body. There's an adjustment to be made from this awareness. And if you've been laying down, taking plenty of time to slowly bring yourself to seated. Noticing the sound of the diffuser, the beating of my heart, the way my fingertips press against each other. In this moment, what's true? What, in very simple awareness, are you noticing? These are the anchors we come back to when our minds drift off into stories that trick our bodies into feeling very real. So you check in with that. Okay, feels real, but is this true? Maybe your hands now remain in your lap, or you can draw them closer to your heart. As a community together, please take a full breath in and a long breath out. The words you speak become the house you live in. It is truly an honor to be here with you today and to be a community who will, in connection with one another, get through this. The light and the truth in me honors and sees that in each of you. Together we say, Namaste. Namaste. Thanks, everyone. Appreciate you being here.
Thank you. Yep. If you guys need anything, please let Heidi or I know. And just spread the word about the online meditation stuff. It's a